The rituals I use depend upon what the game is about. I don't set up a humorous game the same way I set up a dramatic game, but there are a few general rules. Whenever possible, I adapt the dread questionnaire and leading questions for the player characters. I try to think about the game before I play it, and the themes, the genre, what it's about, but I don't make notes that we have to play through. And a simple rule, I stand when I'm running games. It has a dramatic effect on how the play turns out. I began to think about stereotypes as a problem in games over the past few years when I began to think about the concept of gamer shame, as well as initiatives like read an RPG book in public, and just seeing the poor portrayal of role-playing gamers in media and culture over and over and over again. Now, adults can handle this. This is something that we can just deal with and not allow it to have such a negative effect on us. But children can't. And we are losing so much from that. We are losing children who wouldn't take up the hobby because they know that they'll be judged by their peers, adults who won't even talk about it, and all sorts of other different types of ways that the stereotype is making our lives worse for the hobby. And the biggest issue for me is the fact that it is a problem. For me, it's unignorable that there is a problem there. And I don't believe that problems necessarily get better when we don't talk about them. Mine is not necessarily the solution, but at the very least we can put ourselves out there and show that we are normal people. We're not the Big Bang Theory cast at every game of Dungeons and Dragons. Frames are critical for games that involve PvP. Frame protects you from the way that your character is treated. They allow us to separate an action taken against our character from being mentally thought of as an action that is taken against us. And that emotional betrayal and anger, if we're not prepared for it, can bleed through to us, which can cause a lot of people to not enjoy PvP because it makes them angry, and it makes them angry at their friends, which they don't want to be, especially because of a game. This is exactly why PvP is fun in paranoia, but often not so much in D&D. We know what we're getting ourselves into. Alright, let's do this. You've suggested Misspent Youth, which happens to be my favorite game to run. We'll need about 3 to 5 players who can actually get their schedules together. So, anyone who wants to spit in the face of authority, I challenge you to put a comment down below. It will say, "I will stand up." When I began making videos, I didn't know there was an entire community of people doing this already on YouTube. I'd seen one or two, but all I'd seen out there, and it was actually accurate in seeing this, was primarily people playing traditional games such as Dungeons and Dragons. Now, I expected when I started making videos to receive a very negative reaction. Indie gamers often do when they talk about their games to people who have not played them or are not interested in that type of play. And I was pleasantly surprised to receive a very positive reaction. In general though, what is my return on investment? I'm not that interested in subscriber counts. As long as a video I'm putting up has a decent number of people who are interested in seeing it, that is all I really require. So when I see a lot of commitment from certain people, yourself, Natural 20, Tiaku, I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that one right, Brian, Runeslinger, and many others who are very, very interested in what I put out and are very likely to give me a good feedback on that and provide excellent insights of their own, that's what I want. I don't care if I don't reach 1,000 people. And in a certain way, I feel like I'm sort of paving the way for anyone who wants to make videos during or after the period in which I do it, along the same lines. I actually spoke on this topic with Luke Crane a couple of days ago, because he was very interested in seeing what type of reaction I received as well. And we had a discussion on Sunday, and I essentially told him the very same thing. It's also giving me a lot back in that it is forcing me to learn as I go. This a topic, any topic that I talk about in terms of role-playing games, I generally have to research, and I generally have to think a lot about and understand how I really feel and what I really think about these types of issues. And that's really forcing me to learn quite a bit as I go. Any topic that I talk about has been around a while. This is not a new movement. The whole idea of digging into game theory of role-playing games has been around a while, but has really been cooking for the last decade or so. And I haven't really been a part of it until about a year ago, maybe 2 years ago. So I'm learning a lot and I'm catching up a lot. So while the ideas may be new to all of us, they're not new in general. It's a lot to learn, and to even get close to caught up, I will have to keep on piling on new and bigger challenges in my videos as I go. And for me, that is a good thing. And it's one of the biggest things that I get out of this entire project.